Dean brings us vegetables, flowers, and the sod of turf. Nearly always provided for his family. He'd like to scorn, gathering everything up for the winter that lay ahead for his family.
In anima nara, because of Vic, because of the spirit nave, amen. Rev and Chirnavid. Tamid Balsha, on Shahanyu, Consan, a Fogal, Le Nili, McFadden. Falcha, Spashil, the Rev, Aban, Ikela, Annie. Atlan, Eugene, Hugh, Niall, Margaret, Áine, August Gráinne. Ardrafur, Bridie, An Clanar Fad, a Quarsla, a Gaelta, agus a Cortha. So you're all very welcome, everybody, as we gather in the presence of the risen Christ today, as Con put it so well in the little commentary there. Three things that were central and most important to Nalie's life for faith, family, and farming. And one of them here is epitomized by the Paschal candle at the head of Nalie's body today, because Nalie, who lived that faith throughout the course of his life, will readily identify that this is not the end, but the beginning of another journey that lasts into eternity with God in heaven. And we pray that he enjoys the company, the love and friendship of all his family members who have gone there before him, and all who are near and dear to him in this life. And we're praying through the celebration of this Mass and Eucharist that Annie and all the family find comfort, healing, courage and strength through the sacrament today in their loss, and their very sad loss, because they're all a very united family, and when the chain has been broken on that link for the first time, none of us are ever really ready for it or prepared for it. And the nature of the recent days, of course, is a shock as well. So we have to try, and they have to try and come to terms with that. But the Lord is telling us all the time that he's with us. And even though we mightn't feel that, he is carrying us and carrying you at this particular time. So we turn to that God of hope and of the risen Christ to give us strength and courage as we pause in God's presence for a moment. You raise the dead to life in the spirit, Lord, have mercy. You bring pardon and peace to the sinner, Christ, have mercy. And you bring light to those in darkness, Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Nalie, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Kindly be seated again, everybody, as I invite Shane and Orm to lead us in the Word of God today.
The first reading, a reading from the book of Ecclesiasticus. There is a season for everything, a time for every occupation under heaven. A time for giving birth, a time for dying. A time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted. A time for killing, a time for healing. A time for knocking down, a time for building. A time for tears, a time for laughter, a time for mourning, a time for dancing. A time for throwing stones away, a time for gathering them up. A time for embracing, a time to refrain from embracing. A time for searching, a time for losing. A time for keeping, a time for throwing away. A time for tearing, a time for sewing. A time for keeping silent, a time for speaking. A time for loving, a time for hating. A time for war, a time for peace. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jenny Gay Kayla Vishnu, Mosse, Leshna Braver Shin, Shin Ibri Herde.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I am going now to prepare a place for you, and after I have gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, so that where I am, you may be too. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Have you seated, everybody?
when we gather to celebrate the life of any person and come together to celebrate a funeral mass, as we know, there's always a range of emotions that we bring with us. There's also wonderful memories of the person, which is quite true of Nalie in this instance, and of a life well lived, and of faithfulness, of dedication to his family, to his community, to God as well. So while you naturally grieve and are sad, we look at the overall package of a person's life, and we, and you, especially the members of Nalie's family, have received so much from him throughout the course of your lives. And of course, Áine and Nalie and the family were so united together. I know people don't often like to publicly say these things, but it's evident to people in the community. And of course, naturally, when, as I said, the chain of link has been broken on the chain, it leaves us bereft of answers, and especially the fact that, Nalie said to Áine and Loughanure, go to Mass last Saturday night, and then he wasn't there when they came back. He was there, but he just decided to slip away. And to try and deal with that, whether you're young or older, it's always difficult. We don't have any answers to it. We have to live through it. But I think, and you will have shared many fond memories and stories, all of you, over recent days about Nalie. And that's all wonderful in supporting the family, and it's a great Irish trait, and long may it continue, because it holds the person in memory, but in spirit as well. And, earlier we had the power blackout. Well, as I said to Paul there, maybe Nalie was directing operations, but he made sure to get the power back on before we began the celebration of this funeral mass today. So while the person is physically not present with us, we know that Nalie, who had a great spirit, and because he had such a faith, that generation, I was just reflecting on this beforehand, I came from a parents too, who ingrained in us a faith that perhaps we took for granted, and it's no longer evident, unfortunately, in Irish society. But a wonderful blessing it was, when we had a constant attention to prayer, communication with God in our lives. And if we all reflect on that, many my age and older, we'll understand that, and it's seen us through so much in our lives, and especially as we reflect on Nalie's life today, when you think of where Nalie, like so many people, came from at that time, and coming to a community here, and having to leave one that he loved, perhaps in Ranafast as well, and how things were really challenging and tough for people. But I'm not saying this in a morbid way, because people got on with it. They were wonderful. They had a wonderful determination and a wonderful, stickability at things. They just got on with it. They worked together. They worked hard. And that people of that generation. So I really believe that we have so much to be grateful to them for. And maybe we need a bit of that determination today in life. We get hung up on things that are not really important. But always at the heart of life, I guess, for Nalie and Áine and their family was faith, and a prayerful sense of that on a daily basis in their lives. Like so many more of you here, and so many more throughout the country, but we're thinking about the next generations now, and how do we pass that on, because things of the society in which we live in is vastly different to the one which was probably less complex, more simple, the one that we grew up in, and so on. And yet faith is faith. We can, as is often said, it's not taught, it's caught, because it's by the witness of our lives, and Nalie and Áine exemplified that their family, and they in turn are doing that as well, and that's how faith is caught and taught in our lives. So there's a lot to be so grateful for there today. Maybe we can't see it at the moment, in the sense of the way that Nalie lived his life, and in the days and the weeks and months to come, please God, the Lord will reassure you of that, and indeed the value system that Nalie and Áine have given to you, and indeed that you try to carry on with your own closest family and friends as well. And of course, the lovely Gospels that we just read, and all these passages, are very familiar.
but I always find it so reassuring if we have faith that this is the true spoken word of God from St. John, and that he tells us that he has prepared a special place for us. Because again, outside of that generation, the goal that they had was for heaven, really. You know, that nothing else got in the way. And even in my own life today, I have to question, and indeed many of us, we get so sidetracked into so many other avenues of living. Are we really committed if the Lord called us today? Are we committed to what the Lord wants for us and what's best for us, and he knows what's best for us? So in that sense, Nalie, would have turned over, I guess, what the Lord's will was for in his life as he went about his daily work and so on. Just to reflect for a moment on Nalie's, obviously, where, as I mentioned to you, he was born in Ranafest in 1935. And he was a wonderful family of 10, as many of you know. He grew up speaking Irish as his first language. And at the age of 2, he left Donegal and made the historic journey here to Ballygib. He met Annie and his wife and married in 66. As we know, they have six wonderful children, and 3 boys, 3 girls. Eugene, Hugh, Niall, Margaret, Áine and Gráinne, and his 12 grandchildren. He loved farming as already told us in the commentary, and he spent many years working alongside his brothers harvesting potatoes. He also built up his own dairy farm, and he had great love of gardening, which is exemplified by the gifts that we see here before us in the lovely basket, and many people were very lucky to reap his rewards. He was very tasty, and you can see by his farmyard it was spick and span. So again, that exemplifies to us faith, farming and family. And look at the end of the day, aren't these the things that are really important in our lives? And I suppose again, maybe Nalie is speaking to us today to reflect on our lives and see what truly matters and what's important. Decency, honesty, and so on, that generation exemplified as well, that perhaps we don't see today as much, even because I believe that's for another day, but our morals have been extinguished to some extent. And we see that even when we look at the big companies in our society, the lack of morality, the gouging of people with prices and so on, because they have no value system. In the past, even when people were wealthy in Ireland, they had a sense of conscience, a sense of decency and honesty. And perhaps these are things that we need to reflect on again and manifest into our lives, because Jesus tells us all the time, as followers of him, he says, you're either for me or against you, or against me. He doesn't want anything in the middle, which today seems to be the common speak of Irish society. There's no truth, no lies, there's somewhere in the middle. We know that doesn't work really at the end of our lives. If we mean what we say it. If we don't, we shouldn't say it. But that's for another day. But today, we're giving thanks, and we're again thanking God for the long life of Nalie McFadden, for the many blessings that the Lord afforded him, for the wonderful memories he's left you, recognizing too that like all of us as human beings, Nalie was frail and weakness as well, like all of us are on their faith journey, but the Lord raised him up and will continue to raise him up. And we pray for Annie and the family of the Lord through the celebration of the Eucharist now, where Jesus becomes truly present to us on this altar, that they will find that their spirits are renewed and strengthened, and that the power of the risen Christ will come to them in these days of grief, as they also give thanks for Nalie. Arieshke Gorev An An. So I kindly ask you to stand again, everybody, and I invite now Teresa, Kyle, Caroline, and Ty to lead us in our prayer of the faithful.
We pray for all the paramedics who cared for Nalie with such love and compassion, and ask God to bless them in their work. Lord, hear us.
Guimish Aaron Son, Clan Galair, Egon Bronokshaw, Godoga Dia Solas, August Mish Nocturne, Aherna Ashna.
Aherna Bukansa Gazeshna.
We pray in thanksgiving for our neighbours and friends who have been so kind during this difficult time of sadness. May God reward their kindness and bless their homes with happiness and peace. Lord, hear us.
Guimish, your son, Grandad, Winter McFadden, August Minter, Rosil, Kalair, Ada, Emma, Erslina, Verna, Erlav, Yesh, the Grand Field, Aherna, Ashby.
Aherna, the Cancer, Gazation. Margaret, we pause to make our own private prayers and pass them on to God today. Lord, hear us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God. These and all our prayers we make in faith through Christ our Lord. Can you be seated again, everybody? I invite Dean now to bring forward the bread and wine. I think it's Dean, yeah? So sorry. Can't see what it is, sorry. Pray, friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of Nalie, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful Judge who lives and reigns for ever and ever. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we attain together. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, both silent and the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you this day, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and the blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, he broke the bread, and he gave it to his disciples and friends, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples and friends, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us together proclaim the mystery of our faith. Aiesa, furto balsa son, jari tu namar, chucky tu amish. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and the blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May it make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation with our Lord advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Pope Francis, our Bishop Thomas, the order of bishops, religious, clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have called here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your people scattered throughout the world. Remember Nalie, whom you have today called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, remember especially the members of Nalie's family today, and please remember also Rita Heaney, whose funeral mass will be celebrated at the same time in Kilberry here today from Castletown, Kilberry. Give kind admittance to all of them into your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Amen. The Saviour's commandment formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Arnyaha, Atharnyah, Kunye Fadanim, Kutagatariat, Kunye to the Holler and Talim, Paranye to Arnyah. Halleran, doing to doing in you, Agus Maha doing a vapor, Marawakuna the Vekuna Fain, Agus Lalik Shinigaho, Aksir Shin. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And we pray together, Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with each and every one of you. And maybe as an expression of our peace today, we can smile or wave at each other, just conscious of trying to keep COVID down and so on. If you'd like to show your smiles there, or your wave, yeah. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul should be healed. We await a Saviour, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will change our mortal bodies to conform with his glorified body. And just for the distribution of, excuse me, Holy Communion today, we just try to follow a practice that served us well over the COVID time. But in this case, because of the families are in the middle here, Septa will take this role first. And I can take this role at the same time. Then if the other two roles just come when these two roles are completed, if that's okay with everybody. Thank you.
Body of the Lord, When all the angels sing. I really have to go now.
I've just got to spread my wings. P.S. I'll be the first face you see when you get here.
Thank you, Reed. That was lovely, and Pat's were lovely before that too. So let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Nalie may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you, and let us bless the Lord. Just before we have the final prayers of our celebration, just to thank all of you for coming. Obviously in great numbers today, and I'm sure over the last number of days as well. And your support, obviously, and your presence is very much appreciated, I guess, by the McFadden family at this particular time. Thank you to all who took part in the lovely liturgy as a fitting memory to Nalie today, those who did the readings, the prayers, for common, the lovely little commentary, and the gifts that were brought forward at the symbols at the start of our celebration, and for Ian there, that lovely reflection. If we could live by that, I think we'd truly be happy people. And also all of the sisters in very practical ways here today as well. Thank you sincerely. So please stand now for the final farewell. Trusting in God, we've prayed together for Nalie, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Nalie again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Pray for Nalie for a moment as we sprinkle his body with holy water, a reminder of his baptism, of our common baptism. We raise him to the heavens this day with the precious incense, raising him before God, the risen Christ. Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord, to save his soul. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham, to save his soul. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him, to save his soul. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Nalie, in the sure and certain hope that, together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Nalie in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to Nalie, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ. And we are with you and with Nalie forever. Amen. In peace now let us take our brother Nalie to his place of rest. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. And just before we go on the final journey for Nalie to give some to the body of the cemetery, there'll be an opportunity to express your sympathy to the family. I'm sure if you've already done that, you know not to wear them out. If you haven't up to now, kindly do so. And I forgot to mention Eugene and Seamus and Patson for their lovely music and song, which enhanced for energy break today too. Thank you very much.
So for Thank you.